All right, we are going to get started with strength, and then we're going to weave into more of a yoga practice. So coming into a little bit of stretching to the end. So we're going to get a pretty overall workout. We're going to go pretty consistently through without much of a break for a good half of the portion of the class, and then the second half will tear it down a little bit. So we'll kind of shift into a bit of core towards the end, as well as blending it into yoga. So I'm going to have you still grab those light and heavy weights, and we'll get a little bit of a warm up and just work right into our first round, kind of working full space of muscle groups. Grabbing my heavier or mid weights, set the feet about shoulders distance and roll the shoulders back a couple of times. Get them settled down away from the ears. And then just settle into your knees, nice soft bend. Let's start this out with a little stretch down to the knees, dead left, rise back up. Rock your hips back. Keep a little bend in your knees. So as you tip forward, we've got a little cushion there to support the back. But you're going to lift your tailbone to stretch it out. Take it a little slower for 3, 2, and rise to the top. When you lift, lift with your heart, upper back, but try not to arch back or lean back past your hips. Keep it tall. All right, let's row. Take it to the knees, to the hips, to the knees, and rise back up. So waking up the upper back. Every time the elbows bend, squeeze your shoulder blades into your spine. Stay down for 3. Stay here. Pull for 3 and 2 and 1. Rise back up. 3. Now this time back to singles, but I want you to turn your palms and pull out to the side. So instead of pulling to your hips, pull it wide. All right, back to deadlift. Keep the hands where they are. Tip it. Again, lengthen out. Spine is long, arms are long, and the tailbone tips as you tip forward. Stop at the top, we'll go upright. Slide the hands right up the front body. Stop right about mid-chest. Let your elbows lead the way on this one. All right, take it to the top. So we pull it, tuck it, reach it, drop it, flip it down. We'll do that a couple more times. Just taking it nice and easy, following your elbows under, and then flip your elbows up. Keep your hands from flying away from the body. Nice and close. Now this time, stay with your push to the top. Push it up and drop. So I'm kicking my foot back just to give myself a little kickstand. The hands come closer together at the top. Pull back apart and stop the elbows right about shoulder height. 4 more. Here's 4. 3, 2. Now come back down and pause right here. Roll the shoulders back. Turn your thumbs to the front. Curl it up too. Make sure the elbows are cinched right into your ribs so they don't swing backward and they don't lift up in the front, right? So keep them locked to your side. You can keep a fairly loose grip in your hands. Let the biceps do the work. A little bend in your knees. Now we're just going to change it ever so slightly. You're turning your thumbs to the outside. The weights are going to kind of slide back behind the thighs a little bit. Still keeping the elbows right by my ribs. It's really easy to want to do this, and that works your shoulders. We want to keep it to the biceps. Now pause right here. I'm going to flip my thumbs back around again, tip myself just a little bit, taking it to a single lunge, step, sink, bring it in, and curl. Step, sink, bring it in, and curl. Step, sink. So adding the legs to the arms. By the way, our warm-up's done. We just did that. We just went over the shoulders. We're starting to warm up the legs a little bit. And work the biceps. So again, trying to be efficient with our work. So your biceps might be working a little harder if your weight's heavy. Your legs might not be working as much if your weight's light, right? So you decide what feels like a good combination for you. Medium weight. We will work out those legs here in a moment and let the arms take a break. Last time on the right. Now stay back in your lunge, stay here, sit. Rise and sit. So arms are just going to hang by your side. Now that heavier weight might feel better. If you want to switch it up at any point, when you decide you're getting more out of your work, supporting yourself where you need to, keep the shoulders right over the hips. Find your breath. Now take it down to the bottom on this next one and stay here. Just little pulses. We're not coming up for a little while. So turn on the glutes. My right leg's forward, I'm gonna squeeze the buns. Make it work here. Keep going, here's 8, 7, 6, 4, 3. Step in and switch. So step it back for singles, drop. Again, arms are hanging from the shoulders. We're letting the shoulders stay heavy. Just hang on to the weight, it's your resistance. Arms have no other job than just hanging on to that weight. Make sure the knee doesn't pass the toes as you drop. Keeping it nice and tall over the hips. Keep pushing here. Breathe with it. We've got four more, then we'll pulse it out. Last two. Now stay at the bottom, let's get those pulses. Keep it low. Glutes are on, so make it fire. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Breathe into it. You got to keep breathing because we're not done yet. We've got 8 more. Here's 8, 7, 6, 4, 3, 2. Step in. Now we're stepping back to that start to our starting point again. Feet mid, hips width. Step, sit, curl it in at the top. Step, sit, curl it in. Yeah, you want to find a deep enough reach back that you find you're settled between the legs. Front heel is heavy, back heel is lifted. Shoulders stay heavy. Four more. And that's a set of four, right? So we got to work both sides. Almost there. One more in each. Last one. Now pause at the top. I'm going to have you take a combination of either light and heavy, or maybe it's just a single heavy. I'm going to keep my single for right now. If you want to combine together, you can crisscross your weight, hold two weights, working one arm. I'll show you what that looks like. Popping my left leg back, right hand is set, working into our back. Still a little bit of bicep, hanging under the shoulder. Pull. So I want to keep my chest lifted, even keep your eyes out in front. If you look down, your shoulders tend to round, your neck tends to soften. Keep it long. Back foot has got work to do, so I've got my heel up, or you can turn your foot to the outside if that feels better for you and your hips, you and your knees. Your hand stops right at your hip. So make sure we're not pulling up here. We are working a little bit of biceps, but I want you to focus on the upper back and those big lat muscles. Yeah. All right, it's time for those pulses again. Stay up at the top, pulse. Keep it small. We won't go 16 or 24 of these guys. Let it down, come right back up. Keep chest lifted, eyes out in front. Back to singles. Pull, release. So again, you want to feel like it's pretty intense right now. If it's not, grab another little bit of weight. If it's way too much and you can't get the elbow popped up, then loosen up the weight. All right, we're going for pulses again. Here's 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, release, go right back up. Here's 4, 3, 2, and pause right there. Step it in. All right, we're switching it over to the other side. Again, adjust your weight if you feel like you need to make a change. Step it back wide enough that you can lean into the front leg, shoulders back, chest up, and we pull right to the hip. Remember, chest is lifted, eyes are forward. Push through the back leg, whether it's through the edge of the foot pressing down or it's square here. That keeps my hips set. Keep pulling. Shoulders back, using that connection at your leg. All right, it's time for those pulses. Stay at the top. Oh, yeah. Bring it down, right back up. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, release and singles. Pull. Try to squeeze your shoulder blade back into your spine with every pull up to the top. Here's 3 more, 2. Here comes the pulses again. Pulse it up. 7, 6, 5, 4. You got it. You got it. Bring it down one more time. Pulse it up. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and release. All right. I'm going to set my weight down here for just a minute. You can grab a towel, grab a drink. I'm going to peel this layer off. Catch your breath there. We're still working on the back. We're going to kind of take back, transition back into legs again. So from back, we'll move our way into our squats. From here, I'm going to take my lighter weight. So we're working some flies out to the side. So be mindful that you're not straining the neck. Soft elbows, like you're grabbing a big beach ball. Feet are set again, maybe hips or shoulders width. Scoop back just like you're doing your back work with your deadlifts. Tip it over so spine stays long and sweep it out to the side. Flies. Every time you lift, I want you to think about lifting with your elbow. Don't think about your hands. Our hands are always lower and inside of our elbows. So never pulling up here, right? Don't reach with the knuckles. Pull with your elbow all the way to your shoulder blades. Here comes the pulses. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Release, right back up. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. Abs on tight. Good, back to singles. Pull, release. Now, if this gets intense, you can always bend your elbows here, just like we did with our dead row. Here's 4, 3, 2. Here comes the pulses again, up to the top. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Release and back again. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Release. Good, good. Roll it up. Bring it back. Perfect. Set these down. Grab that heavier weight. So combination again, a little bit of back, a little bit of biceps working into your legs, feet are hips distance, sit down for a squat, rise now, dead row. Good, squat, dead row. Squat down. Now, 2 squats on this one. Here's 2, 1, and a single row. 2 single squats. 2 single row. Single down and row. 2 squats. Single row. Single down squats. Single row. Squat last time. Single row. All right, now take just your squats, down and up. What I don't want you to do is let the weight swing out here in front or hinge so deep in the hips that your back comes down parallel to the floor. When you squat, the angle at your shins when they rock forward through the knees should be the same angle in your spine. So we never want it to be too deep here. That throws the work into the back. And low back has a lot of intensity with that one. So make sure you're keeping it strong. It's time for those pulses. Here we go. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, rise up. Let's do it again. 7, 6, sit deeper. Be strong. 3, 2, rise, single down. Drop and push. Oh yeah. Shoulder blades should be cinched tight. Keep sitting. Perfect. Pause right there. Pause right there. All right. I'm going to take my weight, and you've got two choices on this one. You can either take a single weight, hold it right here between your hands. You've got a plate or something like that, hold it in your hands. I like to take these two, set them on top of my shoulders, just take a hold of the front so I've got some support there, and they just rest there. Feet are going to go a little wider. That's why we can't keep them by our sides. Toes stay forward, feet outside the shoulders just slightly. And we'll take it down nice and slow to start. Take it 4, 3, 2, 1, easy up. 3, 2. Now, if you want more weight, grab it, right? You've got options. Your legs are strong. So use what works for you. 4, 3, 2, easy up. Take it down to 2s. Drop it 2. Easy up. Mount it back. And rise. Keep the knees in line with your big toe or the one right next to it. Making sure they're not falling to the inside or trying to push too strong to the outside. Time to single it out. Yeah. Breathe into this one. I'm wondering if you can hear the music. I'm going to turn it up just a tiny bit. Sorry if it's been too dim, too quiet. Four more. Here's 4. 3, 2, and you know what's coming. Pulses at the bottom. Here's 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, rise up. Go right back down. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, good. Back to singles. Breathe with it. Way to sit a little deeper. Can you push the hips back further and squeeze glutes on the rise? Dive it back. Last 2. All right, back to those pulses. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, rise up. We'll go right back down one more time. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, pause right here, pause right here. All right, setting my single dumbbell down. I'm just gonna keep this one. We are gonna combine legs and triceps and make that transition. Hands outside the weight, feet in the same position. Arms go up. Let's start it with just a tricep. Down and up. So my feet are set, but my knees are gonna be soft. Abs on. Good, good. Keep pushing. Elbows stay nice and tight. Make sure they're not swinging out here. Keep them tight into the cheeks, tight into the temples. 4, 3, abs on, 2. Now take those pulses right at the bottom. Pulse, 7. Good, good. 3, 2, rise up, go right back down. Pulse. 3, 2, back to singles, back to singles. Drop and rise, drop and rise. Oh yeah. 3, 2. Now we're gonna lose the pulses and come back to them in a moment. Bring the plate right here in front. We sit and rise, sit and rise. So my elbows are a little bit in front of me. Just let the weight settle into the hands. Shoulders mean they're active. And let's add them in. Push it to the top, push it to the top. So we get a little bit of shoulder work. Again, a little bit of resistance on the biceps. Tricep extension, right? And work in those legs. Push your hips back. Push it back. This is no squat weight, so you have room to sit deeper, and we can endure here. 4, 3, 2. Stop at the top. Bring the hands down to the mat. Drop. 2. Elbows nice and tight. Elbows nice and tight. Keep the knees soft. Abs turned on. Elbows in. Oh, yeah. Now drop to the bottom, single, up. Don't let those elbows start working their way out. Keep it tight. 4, 3, 2. Now step the feet a little wider. You're gonna do pulses at the bottom. 7, yep, knees open. Rise up, do it again. Let's go down. Pulse it, 7, 6, 5. Push your knees out. 3, 2, good, bring the weight in front. Bring the weight in front, sit and push. So the feet are wider now. Toes turn to the corners, knees push to the outside. Your arms have the same job. Drive it up. Now there's a little bit of a lean forward, but not as much. We're keeping it taller, which works your back. Keeping your posture on. And breathe, you gotta sit deep. Now keep the weight at your chest. Let's sit down for pulses. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. Nudge those knees. Push up, back down. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Push up, we're going right back down. One more time. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Push the weight to the top. Sink and rise. Oh yeah. Keep breathing here. 4, 3, 2. Last one. All right. Time to set the heavy weight down. And time to make a little bit of a transition. So we're gonna take it to the mat for a moment, get a little bit of tricep work in again, a little bit of shoulder. So some push-ups, 2 different kinds of push-ups, narrow and wide. So narrow gets our triceps in tight, wide getting the chest, shoulders, and still the triceps. Still an advantage there. Let me skip this back a little bit. All right. So we'll start with wide. We'll start it out. So hands are going to go outside the shoulders, maybe off the mat a little bit. Pull your shoulders back, knees or toes, you decide. We drop it down. 2, rise up. Abs are on here. Tuck the tailbone towards your heel. Keep it snug. Don't let the hips drop down to the floor. Keep them snug. Tailbone to your heels. Let's drop for singles. Now again, if you want to go on the toes, drive it up. You decide where you want to be. Digging deep. You know we've got to do those pulses again. We're just going to do one round. Pulse it to the bottom. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Push it up and pause right there. Walk your hands in so they're under the shoulders. So again, I can go here or I can even go here. I'll start it here for you. Drop it down, rise. So the elbows come in towards your knees. With my knees under my hips, I've got a little bit less intensity. If I rock those hips forward, I take more intensity into the movement. Drop the elbows into your ribs still, no matter what you're choosing. Take it to your toes if you want. 4, 3. We've just got to have one more round of those pulses just to wrap up the triceps. Here we go. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Push up, skip back. All right, take a moment, stretch here. Walk your hands narrow. Take another deep breath in. As you exhale, lift it up. Walk the hands in. All right. If you've got something to lie on, if you don't lie down on your mat, but if you've got like a table, ottoman, something that you can lift up off the floor, I'll have you grab your medium weight. If you had heavy weight for squats, not that way, right? Just a little bit lighter. Get my mat out of the way here a little bit. And come down to lie on the support. If you've got your mat, it's no problem. Just lie down. Weight goes to my chest as I come down to my support. Eyes to the sky. I want to make sure my head's fully supported on the space that you've got. And then I'll take my hips lifted up because they're hanging off the edge. Arms go to the top. Bend your elbows just like we did with those flies. Now we'll take flies in the chest. Hands together. Hands over the shoulders. Drop down. Go 2 of us and 2 up. Just kind of getting our space here, making sure the elbows don't fly past your support. If you're on the floor, you've got that floor to remind you. if you're on a support, then you've got to control to make sure you're not flying way past the shoulders. All right, it's time for singles. Let's go. Drop, squeeze. Now, if your hips are hanging over the edge like mine, I want you to lift them up. Engage the glutes. Press through the feet. Use the breath here. Bring it in, push it out. You know what it's time for. Pulses at the bottom. Here's 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Rise up, right back down. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Back to singles. Drop and rise. Squeeze from your elbows, just like we did on reverse flies. Pull your elbows to the center. Time to pulse again. Here we go. Little ones, hips up. Abs in, rise on up. Let's do it again. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, rise. Bring the weight to your chest. Hug it down. Shimmy my way off that support and step my weights down again. We're going right back to those push-ups. So bring it around. Now we're done with the triceps, so we're just going to focus on chest. Hands go wide. Turning my fingers in a little bit so it's a little bit more comfortable on my wrists and shoulders. Again, you can start with your knees under your hips or walk it back. Pull the shoulders back. Let's drop right into singles. Drop and rise. Keep the head lifted so that you're not looking back underneath you or tucking your chin. Lift your chin up proud. Yes, we've got a pulse. Here we go. To the bottom. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, rise up. Let's do it again. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. You know we're back to singles. Here we go. Drop it down. Push the air out. Stick with me here. This is our home stretch for the chest work, the shoulder work. Breathe into it. And three. We wrap it up with those pulses, and then we're done. Here's 7, 6. Keep the head lifted. Be strong. You don't have to go deep. Bring it up. Back down, down. Ooh. Last 4, 3. Sit back. Now, hands will stay wide on this one. Hips can stay high, but pull back. Open up the chest space. Walk the hands in and lift up. You might take a deeper stretch. Walk the hands around. Open it up. Now we're still going to get strength in here, but we're going to transition to make that bridge between strength and yoga or stretching opening. So I'm going to slide my shoes and socks off. If you've got a yoga mat, go ahead and grab it. If you don't, grab what you have. It's fine. In fact, you may decide you want to do this on a hard surface floor at the start. This will be on our feet here for a little bit. Definitely don't need our weights for this one. I'm definitely going to switch gears here just a little bit. As you catch your breath, grab a drink. Take a moment to find your way onto your mat. We're going to do some standing warrior poses, so some strength here in our postures. And then we'll take it down a notch. So we've got about 5 or 7 minutes here to shift gears. I'm going to have you step your feet out. So I'm on my width of my mat, facing this long edge, toes to the corners. Inhale the arms up to the top. Sit them down, growing sun goddess. Palms up like you're holding something on your hands. Knees push open. We lift up and we sit down. Take a breath when you rise. Push the breath out as you sit. Inhale up, exhale, sit down. Shoulders are nice and heavy. Every time you sit down, I want you to push your knees firmly towards the pinky edge of your foot. And every time you sit down, drop your shoulders down. Now we just finished strength, which involved our squats. This is not a squat, it's a sun goddess. That's kind of like a big, big plie in ballet. So I want my spine to be upright, tailbone heavy. Live strong, sit strong. One more time to the top. Now, when you get to the bottom, you're just going to stay there. Stay there. So, holding and isolating. Shoulders heavy. In fact, feel like your shoulder blades kind of sucking into your ribs. Pull your elbows under a little bit. Suck your shoulder blades into your ribs. Here's that platter of glasses. It's heavy. Shoulders heavy. Knees open. Push them back. Sit down. Tuck your tailbone. Find your breath. Keep it set here. Don't move. Wiggle out your toes. Press to the edge of the feet. Here's four and three. Little rise. Turn your palms. Left foot turns. Warrior two. Lift up through the center. Turn your left foot. Warrior two. Side to side. Here we go. Lift up through the center. Turn your toes straight ahead to the long edge. Turn it to the short edge. Lift it up. Turn to the long edge. Left foot turns to the short edge. Now, if your feet start creeping wider, take a moment when you come up through the center to just kind of walk your feet a little closer, right? And then settle down. We don't want them so close that your knee looks like this in Warrior Two. Past your toes. You want it wide enough that you can keep the knee stacked over the ankle. Lifting strong. Setting strong. Every time you bend the front knee, can you push it to the pinky toe? Make sure it's not falling to the inside. We've got one more time to the other side. Now this time, as you come back to Warrior Two on the right, I want you to stay there. And little pulses, little pulses. Good, I like the pulses today. Shoulders heavy. Arms are long and strong, but don't make them go here, right? Pull them down. Suck those shoulder blades into your ribs. Push through the long edge of your foot. The long leg, just like you're pulsing the front, it's strong. Seven, six, keep pushing. Oh yeah. Now pause here. Lift it up through the center. We turn it to the other side. Settle down and pulse. Make sure the pulses aren't sending your knee way past your toes. So walk it out. This is opening and strengthening all at the same time. Shoulders heavy. Squeeze the elbows. Be strong here. Press to the edge of the long leg. Out through the edge of your feet like they're blades cutting into the mat. Breathe, breathe. Here's four and three and two. We're rising through the middle. Turn it, flip it around again. Find your warrior two. Now, don't worry, we're changing it up here. You're going to settle into warrior two. Be strong here. Take a reach forward. Reach through the ribs, core strength, then pull it back. Core strength, reach. So it's like you're heading towards your side angle, but you don't quite ever get there. Spine is long. I create this straight line from my head down to my left foot and my head to my tailbone here. So reaching, tipping, and pulling back. Arms are long and strong. Shoulders are still heavy. And this knee is just stabilizing, pushing out to the edge. Make sure it doesn't fall in here. Push, push it to the pinky side. Press through the edge of this long leg. Good, good. Keep going. Reach it over.
Stress.
Bring it back. You've got one more time. Bring it over. Take it back. Turn back through the center. Take those arms. Inhale up. Turn your toes to the corners. And then brush it out. Inhale up. Exhale. Just giving your arms a little break from holding the legs, a little flushing. Inhale up. Exhale. Push the knees open every time they bend. Got one more breath. Inhale to the top this time. Pause. Turn to your left side again. Strong, open, full. Warrior two. Settle the arms. We're reaching to the left. Reach it out and pull it back. Stack the shoulders over the hips. Reach it out and pull it back. Remember, it's long spine, tipping, angling head to heel. Bring it back, stacking head over tailbone. And every time you have an opportunity, push your knee towards the pinky toe. Arms are floating, but they're strong, right? We should feel it here at the shoulders. Breathing through it. Keep nudging the knee. If you've got room, open up your stance. This is strength and opening at the same time. I know it's crazy. But you've got this opening in your hips, strength to hold that opening. two more. One more time. As you come back to the center, turn your toes to the corners. Again, exhale, inhale, big breath. Exhale, scoop it in. Inhale, float it up. Exhale, scoop it in. Inhale. Now I want you to follow your breath pace. We're just gonna come right into flow here, taking it out of strength. So your pace is gonna increase with your breath. Brush it out. When your breath comes in, float it up. Your pace might be very different than mine, so don't worry about matching our pace. Don't worry about matching the pace of the music. I want you to be in tune and connected with your breath. Exhale. Big breath in. Every time you sit, push the air out. Float up. Pull the air back in. Two more breaths. As you come down, pause here, float about halfway. Put your hands on your thighs, fingers toward the inside. Press the heel of the hand, rock it side to side. Walk it out a little wider if you need to. Again, same rules apply. Knee doesn't pass the toes. I'm leaning forward on this one, however, so my spine is still long, but hinged. So, leaning here. Hips are way back past my heels, as you can see. My ribs are forward, but my hands are here to support my back. Now, as you keep sliding side to side, start nudging your shoulder a little bit. So we get a little twist here. A little twist. And as we're twisting, we're dropping the shoulder down, right? Top shoulder pulls back. You're using your hands, your arms, your legs for support to deepen that twist. I'm using my hands to nudge my knee towards my pinky toe again to open the hips. So anytime you can take it wider, if you've got room, I want you to do it. Here's four, and three, and two. Let's pause in the middle, pause in the middle. So, while we pause, turn your toes toward the long edge. So my feet are parallel to the edge of the mat. Gently drop the heart. Bring your hands to the floor. If you've got a book, even your weight is a good thing to put your hands on so that the spine is long. I want you not to be getting to the floor like this. Try not to round, flat back. Your feet can be as narrow or as wide as you want, but it's still a wide stance, whether it's just outside the shoulders or bigger. Now to get to the floor, it helps to have that wide stance. So my right hand stays down. Left hand reaches out. Press the floor away, turn into a twist. Hold it right there. Now, right hip. It's going to want to fall down. Can you pull the right hip up? Keep the hips square. Push to the edge of the feet. Take a big inhale here. When we exhale, scoop it under. Reach over towards your right foot. Tuck it through into a twist. Push the floor away. Turn your twist to the ceiling. Reach the arm up and tuck it under. Now maybe the shoulder lets it happen. Maybe you need to bend your elbow here. That's fine. Try not to reach behind you as you come to the top. So make sure it doesn't look like this. Palm under. It's palm open. And thread it through. Maybe it's here, right? Find what works through your shoulders. You're pushing through the right hand and tucking strong. A little core strength. Spinal twist. Breathe in. Breathe out. One more time. This time as your hand comes down, just pause here. We're softening our elbows, dropping the head round the spine, drop into a straddle. Your hands can walk back under your elbows, drop the head so it falls heavy, or maybe it even lightly touches the floor. Pull your shoulders up away from the floor. Can you lift your tailbone a little bit? Take a really deep breath in. And a deep breath out.
on your next inhale, lift the head just enough to lift the floor, walk the hands back under the shoulders again. So again, if you need your support, block, hook, something under your hands, find that long spine, left hand stays down. Right hand reaches up, let's just pause this twist, hold it. So again, if you can only go so far and your spine, your shoulders are telling you different, soften your elbow, hand to hip is a good one. Do what you can to lift your open left hip. I'm gonna push it towards my left foot, keep it square. Take an inhale up and an exhale, tuck up. What we wanna do is try to keep our hips from moving side to side. So press out through the edge of the feet, be strong through the bottom half so that we can focus on the top half. Round down through the left hand as you reach up. Push the floor away, tucking the bottom shoulder and pulling the top shoulder back. And again, you're finding your home, right? Where is it that your body gets the most range, the most support, the most strength, the most opening? Two more. Keep those hips set. Last one coming up. And again, come right back down. Hold, soften the spine, walk the hands back, drop your head. Lift the tailbone. Feel free to turn your head left and right, nod back and forth, find some softness there in the neck. Deep breath in. Deep breath out, and on your next breath, walk your hands back under your shoulders, soften the knees, just stay right here, just kind of walk my feet in, toe heel, until I can gently bring the knees down to the mat, and knees to the mat, turning to my short edge, cinch my hair here, so as we turn to the short edge and come to the floor, making a little transition into a bit more opening, we'll take some strength here and there, so find your way into downward facing dog. Walk your feet back, spread the fingers out, walk the hips up. Just begin to kind of move it a little bit. Pedal here. Let your hips rock and roll this way, so you don't have to keep them set. Let your shoulders even rock and roll a little bit if you want. Just find your home here. A couple more breaths, walking the knees. Your next breath, take both legs long. Melt your heels, a little bend in your knees. Hopefully you can find some space here as we go. So lift your tailbone, push your ribs back towards your thigh bones, and slide your shoulders from your ears to your hips. Dangle the head, turn, nod. Perfect opportunity to decompress the spine here. So take advantage of your heavy head, tugging the spine, relaxing the neck. Now on a deep breath in, right leg rises to the sky. That right leg's gonna lift up and open. It's natural here. Sometimes we like to turn our hips to more of a split. Maybe it's pointing the toes, maybe it's a flex. It's an inhale up and an exhale. Looks to your hands, rocks forward. Take your left knee down and bring the right foot through to a lunge. So my hips are gonna rock forward and back a little bit. We want the back knee to be far enough back that you feel some space here in the hips as you rock forward. So make sure it's not really crowded like this. Great. Move it back. Take like a full lunge and then knee goes straight down from there. If you need a little cushion for this back knee, hold it. Grab a towel, grab a blanket, drop it under your knee, give yourself a little support. I flip my back toes under and just let my toenails kiss the mat. One more reach back. This time, rock it forward. Mouth the hips. Pull your shoulders back. If giving your hands to the floor is crazy challenging, again, a book, a block, under one or both hands. That helps you lift the chest. Just brings the floor closer to you, whatever height helps work for you. Melt your hips forward. We want to feel space happening right here. Shoulders pull back, heart lifts up. Let's transition our hands to our thigh and push the heart back without letting the hips move. So not here, right? Keep the hips heavy. Push here. Heart lifts. Hips stay melted forward. And you can go wherever you want with this. Take whatever options work for you. My hips don't change. They're still melting towards the front foot. Left hand might reach up to the top. A little bit of opening. A little bit of strength of balance. Maybe both lines. Hard or linked. Lots of choices. Pull a deep breath in. As you exhale, let the hands fall, drop the heart down. Pause here. I'm going to set my block aside. Unfold my mat. Lift the hips high. Step back to down dog. Walk it out again. Spread your fingers out. Pull your shoulders back. Melt into both heels. Legs go long. Tailbone rises. Again, nice deep breath. Let's try the other side. Left leg rises. Again, I can flex or point and maybe spin those hips, make it a little bigger. Push the ribs back. Deep breath in. Melt into the right heel. One more deep breath in. As you exhale, lift to your hands. Draw the knee forward and take the back knee to the mat and step the foot here. Again, snag your block. If you want a little support, a little lift, grab what works for you. Space between the knees, all the same rules apply. As you rock back, you can find as much length as you want in the front leg to open up the hamstrings a bit. Keep it moving, front to back. Again, always that option. Take a little cushion under your knee. Back foot is flipped under so the toenails rest on the mat and the back foot can relax. One more rock to the back. And this time as you rock forward, really melt into it. Slide the shoulders back, lift the head. Feel like your hips are being magnetized to this front foot. Melting forward. While your hips stay exactly as they are, let's transition the hands to the thigh. And push the heart back without letting your hips chest crowd. It's a little bit of a back bend, so this is much for your back. You can come back here. Think about your hips. Work on that space. Or maybe you can take the right arm up. Again, it doesn't have to be as much of a back bend. I can stay right here or reach back. Maybe even match the other side. Find what works for you. Keep breathing. One more inhale. Exhale, dive the hands right back down to the mat. All right. Take another again. Unfold of the mat. Set the block off to the side. Lift your hips high as you step back for down dog. One more time. Walk it out. Now we are going to split again, but this time transitioning to opening up the rest of the hip space, the legs. So take the right leg to the side. And the right leg is going to come through to a pigeon position. My knee comes forward, turns to my right elbow, and then I drop my knee down and scoop back. So if I'm to show you on this angle, my knee is here. It's tipped over to the side, so it's outside my right arm. The foot can come as far as parallel, right? So foot and knee in line. I like to be at a bit more of an angle because that's what my hips allow me to do. This isn't about your knee. It's about supporting your knee based upon what your hips can do. Now I want to create distance between my knees. So instead of being here, tuck my toes and try to reach back. Open up this space again. Push the mat away a little or a lot. It's again the back end. So if your back is something you're watching, walk your hands forward. Maybe stop right here. A little bit of a neutral spine. Find your breath. Be confident and be comfortable here to let go on your exhale. Let your weight melt into the mat, melt into the opening. while we think about releasing the legs, finding our opening here, I'm going to give you two options. The first one is to lean out of this and open up the quads. So I lean over to my right side, drop to my elbow, curl my back leg, opening up my quads. If you could reach back and hook onto the foot, here's your release, right? Opening quads and hips. If you feel okay and you want to go into a king pigeon, I'm going to come right back where I was, right back in that same pigeon position. Tuck my toes, lift my foot, lift my foot to a tucked position. Reach back and see if I can hook on. Try to go to the inside. This is a good chest opener too. Come to the inside. Now I can slide my back knee, hold my heel, that's your quad release. Maybe you can even go deeper where your elbow hooks the right of the foot. So again, this can be big or small or off to the side, just like so. Right? Find your hold. I want you to find about 5 good full breaths, whatever you've chosen. And when you release that 5th breath, come back to pigeon if you're tipped to the side, or release the foot back. Just get comfortable set here and relax down to your mat. Now I've got my block close by. If I feel still a little bit crowded here and tight, I can go just like this. Whatever gets you released to the front so that you start to find your breath again. Find pace in your breath, slowing down. Allow your body to melt into the mat. Relax the neck. Put the shoulders heavy here just a little bit. You begin to take your next full breath. Start locking your hands back under your shoulders, lift your heart. Tuck the back toes. I'm just going to give a little space here to release the front leg. Come right back into down dog. And in your down dog, take the right leg, move it around a little bit. Find your way back to full down dog. Take a breath to reach the left leg up. So safety rules apply on the side. We'll rock forward. Bring our knee outside the left elbow. Again, slide back. Walk the hands in under the shoulders. Pull the shoulders back into the chest. You can tuck the toes. Lift and scoot the knee back a little bit if you want. Turn myself to the other side so I can show you that second release when we get there. So really, we're just testing the waters here, see what feels right. More angle in the front leg, maybe a bit less. So the room to scoot the back knee or to maybe lift the chest. Now again, as we find our way to the quad release, you can stay right here, tuck your toes, curl the heel, and reach back inside. Pull in. So modified king pigeon or crab pigeon. Maybe you pull the elbow a little tighter, or pull the heel in, or scoop the elbow around the foot. If this doesn't feel like you on the side, lean over to the left, drop down to your elbow. Let's see if we can reach back and hook onto the foot. Draw the knee behind you. Make sure it doesn't stay up here. You want to open up the front body. Put the knee on the mat. Maybe give yourself a little touch point to puff the chest out. Create space from your kneecap across the front of the hip, even across the chest and shoulders. So whether you're here or in more of a king pigeon, scooping in, lifting the chest, Find those five breaths.
And you release the last breath. Go ahead and melt back leg. Shift back into your pigeon if you need to. And now soften down toward the floor. So we start dropping the head, releasing the shoulders. And just taking these few breaths to melt into your pigeon. Let the body sink into the mat and let gravity take over. Allow yourself a bit of space to release the neck, the head become heavy. Slow the breath pace down just a little bit. Shoulders. As you lift, I'm just going to get a little tuck to my foot, a little space for my knee. Just move back to down dog. Take the left leg, move it around a little bit. Get some room to unkink there from that posture. Feel the mobility, the space you've created. Walk it out a little bit. Just come down to your knees. Sit back either on top of the heels here, or if that's uncomfortable, you can come up here, fold your mat again just by taking a little pull and a fold, right, to give cushion if you'd like. And from either seated or lifted, link the hands behind the back. Extend the elbows, lift the chest, squeeze the shoulder blades. If this doesn't feel like much, let the arms rise. Next exhale, relax the arms, unlink the hands, inhale up to the top. I'm going to take a link onto my right wrist and just pull to one side. So again, I'm up here doing the same thing. Just stretching, linking onto the right wrist to tug the arm across. Right back up to the top again. Bend the right elbow. Put your hand down towards your back and just hook onto the elbow here. Pulling across the top. If that feels intense on your shoulder, bend your elbow, come across here. On your exhale, release that grip. Take it to the other side. So again, reaching back from my back and hugging the elbow in. If that again feels like it's a little too much, and across the front. One more breath. As you exhale, release. I'm going to take this fold back out of my mat. Come to seated. Hook your feet to the short edge of your mat. Before we come all the way down to the floor, hook onto the backs of your legs. Lift up proudly, so push the sit bones down. Feel what it's like to feel the shoulders pull back, heart lift up, nice proud lift in the chest. And we're going to slowly roll and open up our back as we come to the floor. So begin by tucking your tailbone. Start pulling your tailbone under.
pulling the sit bones under. Tucking back onto the sacrum just above your tailbone. Pull the belly button in, really squeeze tight through the core. Start tucking your chin. Now let your shoulder blades peel apart. Stretch it. Let the arms lengthen. Hang onto your legs until you've found the most rounded spine you can. Tuck the chin. Hang onto the legs. Hang onto the legs. Long arms cinch onto the legs. Hold it there for just a few breaths. Really deep opening through the mouth. Take your next few breaths. You can just let the grip go. Slowly uncurl the spine down to the mat. Take a deep breath in. Stretch as long as you can. A deep breath out. One more time. Squeeze your elbows. Link your fingers. Point your toes. Big breath in. Big breath out. We're going to do it one more time. I want you to squeeze as tight as you can, as long as you can. Lift your ribs. Breathe in, breathe in, breathe in. As you exhale, relax. The arms melt. The legs melt. Maybe your feet walk a little wider. Find a place where your arms feel most comfortable to relax the elbows and the hands. Relax the shoulders. Let your head melt into your mat. Neck go soft. Take a deep breath in, fill the belly. As you exhale, let it dribble down to your toes. The feet relax. The knees go soft. The thigh bones heavy. Your hips sink into the mat. All of the spaces that touch your mat become just a little heavier. Deep breath in. And deep breath out. In yoga, when we come to Shavasana, our final posture. It's a posture of comfort and release. If lying on your back with your legs long is not comfortable to you, try bending your knees, stepping your feet apart, leaning the knees together to support the back. If sitting upright on your side is better, find what feels most comfortable to you here. Taking the same mindfulness to let the spaces of the body know. Become connected to your breath again. Not following your breath, but guiding your breath. Inhaling through the nose. And exhaling through the nose. Allowing the body to calm and settle. Allow your mind to pause and settle. Creating space for stillness that allows you to just bask in the energy that you've created, of strength, opening. So follow your breath, settle your thought, and pause. Thank you.
breath in. Deep breath out. Stretch, let go. Let the movement gradually run. Find your way to slower movements, bigger movements. Gradually let that movement bring you back to a comfortable seated position. Let's take a deep breath together. Reach your arms to the sky. Inhale. As you exhale, bring your hands together to your heart. Just pause so you can close your eyes. Acknowledge one thing that you appreciate about your body. Deep breath in. Deep breath out. Pause to acknowledge your breath. Its power to support and to comfort. Take a deep breath in through the nose. And this time, open the mouth and sigh the breath on the exhale. And a moment to acknowledge your energy. Maybe something that resonates with you now. Your movement, your strength, your opening, your pause. That with you. Let's take one more breath together. Deep breath in through the nose. Sigh the breath out. Honoring the light in each of us. Namaste. Thank you for trying a little combination of strength and yoga. If you haven't tried either before, thank you for giving it a try and try it again, right? Do this a couple of times. Try strength by itself, yoga by itself, and just start mixing it up a little bit. Find some variety. Thank you. Have a great morning, day, or evening.